Hi, welcome to the Coffee Chat Show here on Buzzin Pattaya, the show where we talk about things that are happening right here, right now, as well as general news, tips, information, and advice. Now, joining me on the sofa today is John. How you doing, my man?
Oh, good, man. Thank you.
Can you, like, look, break my hand? You know what I mean? I mean, Jesus Christ. I mean, what's going on with these guns,
son? I need to stay off the protein shakes.
Hey, God, dear. I mean, you know, that's a set of guns you got there, isn't it?
I'll stick to the water, no more protein shakes.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you're going to stick to that. You broke my hand. I mean, bloody hell. Now, joining me is John. John, now, you're here in Pattaya. Now, you're the manager of the Cave, aren't you? LK Metro.
Yep.
Yeah. Before we talk about that, what I want to do is I want to go back in time.
Back in time.
And I want to go back to when you were originally, where are you originally from?
Edinburgh, Scotland.
Edinburgh?
Yeah.
See, I thought you were Welsh. See, look, I love it, I love it. That teaches you a squeezing man.
That's it.
That's because you're squeezing. No, get off.
Could be Welsh, could be
See, you're from Edinburgh.
Yeah.
Wow, have you ever been to the Edinburgh Tattoo?
I have, yes.
Yeah, what an amazing
it's
show.
It's an amazing event. Everyone from all over the world.
Yeah, I went there. I watched that when the military do all that thing. It was just like unbelievable, unbelievable. Amazing. So, from Edinburgh, what were you doing in Edinburgh?
Personal trainer back home.
Right. Have you always been in the fitness?
Yeah, I've always been into fitness from a young age, like sports and stuff, and then getting into like.
And what's your best sport?
Football, but that doesn't mean I'm any good though.
Well, judging by the size, I can't see you being that mobile.
Better for rugby, maybe a good goalkeeper.
I was going to say, a good goalkeeper. Good you don't goalkeeper, need to move, just try and get the ball around me. you just put your hands there, will you?
That'll do. Stick it through my legs and then run around me, yeah.
I mean, you've gone from Edinburgh, obviously, in the fitness world, etc., etc., and now you find yourself over here. I mean, when was the first time you came to Thailand?
I wasn't actually prepared for all these questions.
That's okay, good.
That's
don't worry.
That's fine. I think it was 2016. I got my passport in June 2016, and I came here for the first time in November 2016. It was actually when the king had passed away. Rest in peace to the king of Thailand. Yeah. King number 9?
Yes.
Right, it was when he had passed away. I came like just as the funeral morning had finished. And I didn't even know if the bars were going to be open.
Yeah.
Because, you know, obviously part of the reason I was coming over was to have a drink and etc. And I think it was like the day after I came, and we didn't know if all the bars were going to be open, but they were.
Yeah.
But rest in peace to the King of Thailand also.
And I mean, when you came over, I mean, without stating the obvious, what was the reason you came in? You know, had you heard about Pattaya before, or was it just a case of like your mates had mentioned it? I mean, what made you come here?
Well, not mentioning obvious reasons, like you said, you know, a seaside town is always a nice place to go, a tropical place too. Just the whole, you know, alien thing of it, just being so far away from home and everything just so different, the culture, the food. I love that because I just got bored of the UK, you know what I mean? I just wanted something new, and then I booked myself here for 2 weeks, and it was just like every day waking up like, wow, walking outside palm trees, you know, there's no palm trees in Scotland, so it was just you know, completely.
Well, if you have got palm trees, they're normally in furniture showrooms.
They're on TV,
I went to Oban once, and I have to say, the fishing bit, it was just absolutely stunning. Yep. It was just... Yeah. You know, from being from London to going all the way up there to this place called Oban, and it
completely
was just
different from London.
Oh, it was brilliant. It was, and the people were saying, and one of the things in my memories that reminds me of Oban was, and I'm not talking out of turn, I'm just saying it was, but I remember going to a fish and chip van.
Right.
And on the menu, it was haggis and chips.
Oh, that sounds good.
And do you know what? It was hilarious because, like, being from London, you know, we never had any of that. So, like, all my mates are egging me on saying, go on, go and ask for haggis and chips. And I thought, right, do you know what? Let's do it. So I walked up, I said, hello. I said, can I get haggis and chips, please, mate? But yeah, no dramas. And it was like asking for sausage and chips.
Yeah,
like,
a regular thing.
And he put this, it was like a ball
in
this chips. And I was just like, okay. But it was so nice.
Good.
Oh mate, haggis is so nice.
Haggis is brilliant. Yeah, I do miss it. You're throwing these in here, these haggises and iron brews, and you're making me wanna.
Oh mate, honestly, but do you not find? I mean, obviously you've been here a while. How have you adapted to like missing your home comforts? Because you know I've been here 10 years, and even now I still miss certain things. You know, I look at things. Oh, I wish we had that. You know, but how do you find it?
It's hard. It is because essentially, you know, I do eat some Thai food and. Talk about food, we'll talk about haggis and stuff. I do eat some Thai food and some Western food, Farang food. I miss like a good fish and chips. I do find it hard to get like a chippy fish and chips. Like you can go to these places that serve the Western food and it's good, but it's just not what I'm used to back home. Fish and chips with like salt and sauce and stuff, brown sauce. And
see, you're doing it to me now, aren't
chippy
you?
Chippy sauce and stuff like that, And haggis as well, you can get haggis over it, but I'm talking about like the haggis that you had, the fried haggis.
I
want that.
Yeah.
Mince and tatties.
Oh, dear. See, the one thing I miss probably more than anything especially like being from London, is we are only literally a 5 minute walk away from a Chinese takeaway.
Right, well, the Chinese
out
food
here,
back home's different from
yeah,
what you get
out here. Oh, it's just awful.
Yeah, you can't get a Chinese. It's all like watery soups and stuff. We want the whole deep fried MSG.
Yeah. I mean, you know, to have a chicken curry, egg fried rice, portion of chips, and crispy seaweed with prawn crackers. I mean, honestly, I
know what I'm doing after the interview. Yeah. I'm going to get some food. Look at
honestly, but you know, but you're right, though. You can't find a Chinese. I mean, we used to have Wok and Rock. And there used to be, in Soiba Cowhead, there used to be a really good English-style Chinese restaurant, but sadly shut down. And Wok and Rock used to be like a delivery place.
Right, yeah.
But they've just gone, which is a
real
shame.
There is actually a place on Soilenki.
Okay.
It's Hungry Panda and the Grill. And I would say that's probably about the closest you can get to a UK Chinese.
Well, then you know where you're going. Now I know where I'm going.
Let's go do it. Let's go do it.
I mean, when you come over, I mean, how did you find it adjusting to like the heat and to the culture? And what was the biggest challenge for you?
Yeah, the heat was massive for me, obviously, being from Scotland. And when I came over here, it was November 2016. So it was very, very cold in Scotland. Oh, I was in the airport like this. And then coming over, stepping out in the Bangkok airport, Suvarnabhumi, it was like... What the? You know, the heat just hit you from all over.
Don't tell me you had a jumper on still.
I probably had my North Face jacket on. And then I walked out of the doors into the actual heat outside, and I seen the palm trees, and the heat hit me from the feet up, and I was like, I just fell in love right away. I thought, this is crazy.
Yeah.
What is this? Yeah. I've never felt like this before, because it was kind of one of my first holidays. So
I think one of the biggest things that people find a challenge is when you get off the airport, especially if you're going down the external steps, and it is hot, and you automatically think, oh, get away from these turbine engines. They're blowing the heat at me. And then you realise actually the turbine engine's blowing the other way, like this is the real heat.
And it can
get really, really hot.
And then you're in the taxi, you've obviously not had a great sleep from the flight and stuff. You're in the taxi and it's just so hot in the taxi. And this Thai guy is obviously driving the taxi. He's used to the heat, and you're not, and you're in the taxi like, oh my God, I'm so tired, I'm so hot, you just want to get to your hotel and get a shower.
I mean, you've been here now a few years. I mean, in terms of like adjusting to life here, I mean, it's obviously like temperature and food and stuff, but actual living here, you know, we come here as a holidaymaker, and of course we live the dream, we have our 2 weeks, whatever. I mean, actually living here is a huge difference to actually holidaying here. I mean, how have you found that transition? What's been your biggest challenge?
It's hard to kind of get the balance between, you know, having a good night out and also, you know, staying fit and healthy and not, you know, and staying mentally fit too, because a lot of guys that have come here, they stay here for a long time and all they do is just hit the alcohol. For me, I do the opposite side of that, and I try and keep fit and stuff, you know, because if you're hitting alcohol hard, you're not training, you're gonna lose a lot of focus and stuff. That's not what I would say is a good idea. It's good to keep a balance and try and eat healthy and have your nights out too and stuff. When you're on holiday, that's fine, you have your 2 weeks out drinking every night and stuff, but when you're living here, you learn quickly that costs money, and it's cost your health too in the end. So I have seen a few people go down the slippery slope of, you know, just drinking and treating it like a 1 year holiday, a 2 year holiday, and soon you'll have no money left and you'll be very unhealthy. So
one of the questions I want to ask you, and it's playing on my mind a little bit, because
it's going to be a good one.
Well, I don't know, you'll have to tell me. I think it's a good one, but one of the questions I want to ask you is, you know, when we're back in England, I mean, you're a young guy, you know, good looking guy, in very good shape, fair play to you, and I respect you for the effort and the attitude.
Thanks,
that
mate.
You do that.
Yeah.
When you're going out into a nightclub back home, you know, you're going to go in a club and you're going to get the attention from some of the girls, etc., etc., and then you're going to, you know, make contact, whatever you do.
Right.
But out here, how does that affect you? Because pretty much 9 out of 10 girls are going to go, but you've got to pay me.
Yeah.
And you're like, well, hang on, like, I don't normally do this. Like, you know, I mean, when you get to my age, you're grateful.
Yeah. You know what I mean? You're like, okay,
just how much.
Just take it.
But I mean, for a young guy, how does that, because I'm trying to think about how I would feel. If I was your age and your shape, et cetera, and I went out like Ibar or whatever, you know, the amount of freebies that you may possibly get to the amount of things that are financial transactions, how do you get around that?
Well, essentially, if you were going to be looking to meet up with a lady, and you have more choice then, I suppose. I don't think it's a good idea to talk about freebies and stuff. I don't think that's... because it does annoy a lot of people and stuff. So I don't really want to go down that route of talking about that. Essentially, you should pay every lady if she's looking for that, if that's what she wants.
Have you had a freebie?
Never.
Never?
Never.
See all that time
in the
gym.
You didn't even listen to what I said. You didn't listen to what I said there.
Well, you did. You said you want to touch on freebies. Now you're not going to talk about it. And you said never.
I think when you talk about things like that, and you're living here, and guys are back home, it can make them very angry, because they either disbelieve you or they they're angry that you know you do that. So.
Oh no! I mean, guys, I've had loads of freebies. I pay in the morning. It's much easier.
pay them a leave.
That evening it was free. In the morning it's like, okay, no worries.
In the morning it's paying to go. Yeah.
I mean, in terms of going out, I mean, where do you go to place? Where do you like to go? I mean, obviously, I appreciate right now things are a little bit difficult because they're closed, etc. But I mean, in terms of going out,
just before everything like closed recently, I would obviously say LK Metro, and I'm not plugging LK Metro because I'm in the cave. LK Metro is the place to be. Tree Town, Soy Bacal is an amazing spot. Soy 6 is pretty much done for. We've got our fingers crossed it can come back, obviously. I mean, most of the guys that come here like a bit of Soy 6. Walking Street. Wow, I don't know what to say about that. But Tree Town is a really cool area. It's nice the fact that, you know, you can sit in Tree Town, you can eat, you've got all the little bars around. Essentially, if you wanted to wander off for a massage somewhere, you've got that. Soy Bacal's the area, man.
Yeah, I mean, I must admit, LK is really popular. Really Soy Bacal, nice. Very good. Tree Town, as you said. Soy 6, I think, will survive. I'm not quite sure about the way...
But it will take a long time for Soy 6 to gradually...
Yeah, go, and I think they've got to overcome the live streaming aspect and try and put that one to bed. I know it's a hot topic right now, and I understand why they do it. But they need to put that to bed at some level or other, and how they do that...
I think it will. I think within time, it'll run its course. They may move it upstairs to a room where they can just dance for the drinks. But essentially, when a lot of these guys come back in their you know, the hordes, they can't have that in the bar.
Absolutely.
If you've got like a group of 10 guys walking and ready to spend money, and you've got girls dancing on a camera, you know, the managers will quickly see that that's not going to work.
Yeah, and I agree with you about Walking Street. I mean, Walking Street is it's heads or tails. It's, you know, really what's going to happen?
I was talking to Phil from the pub, and he was like, "Look, he's like, it's really, really bad." But he's the thing, the upper hand he has, he's got his YouTube channel just now.
People
will go see him no matter what. They won't need to be walking down Walking Street. They'll go see him directly.
Yeah, yeah.
So the people that are on the YouTube game just now are the smart ones, essentially.
Yeah, and I mean, a little birdie whispered in my ear not so long about I should ask you about Soy 6. I mean, what's your Soy 6 history? Wow. He's taking a deep breath.
I'm scared for your channel. If I say anything, the stories that I could tell you about Soy 6. I worked on Soy 6 for 2.5 years, and the stuff that happened down there is just, it became, you know, natural. It just became an everyday thing. You would see like big crazy fights and just all sorts going on everywhere without getting too graphic. And it just became natural. It was just people would be like, John, look. And I'm like, I'm going to the toilet, I don't really care. And I'm like, really? But there's like five girls fighting. I'm like, I see it every day.
Yeah. Do you miss it?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Well, the girls fighting or Soy 6 or both?
Right. Yeah. Right now, I do miss it because everything's closed. It'd be fun to see some ladies fighting and stuff, but not. I do miss it. I miss like just being on Soy 6, seeing all the girls walking past, seeing all the guys going past, looking in the bars, getting pulled into the bars and stuff. It was fun to watch, you know.
Yeah.
And talking to all the managers on Soy 6, there's always different personalities.
Yeah.
There's always new managers coming and going and stuff. It was cool to meet them. And
I mean, when you talk about Soy 6 and about here in Pattaya and the things that we see, and you know, I totally get what you're saying because, you know, I'm often around all these areas like you are, and, you know, it just becomes normal. How do you find your friends interact with you back home when you tell them that this is just normal? Because for me, my mates are like, really? Like, are you sure?
I don't have any friends from back home anymore. Like, they've like disowned me because of my life here.
Really?
Like they're so jealous that they, like, I think I've got like two people that talk to me now, seriously.
Wow.
I've got like a Facebook from back home with like 2,000 friends on it, and they're all people I know, right? The Pattaya one I've got, the Facebook, it's not all people I know, but that one from back home, if I posted a photo of me and a lady having a drink or something, I probably wouldn't even get any likes. Because that's the mentality, because people have not been here.
Wow, that's incredible.
Seriously, that's true. And it's a sad thing because I would love to tell a lot of these guys my experiences and get them over.
Yeah, for sure.
It's just like, I don't know. You know the mentality is, oh, it's all ladyboys. And the population of Thailand is all men.
Yeah, well, we were talking about ladyboys off camera, so we won't go down that road again. Well, I was talking with John about my nano experiences and the two in Walking Street, and you know, Bless my mum. She still talks to me and she watches these videos.
Wow. My mum will be watching this video too, definitely.
Excellent.
Yeah, she likes
so
shall
I, do you want to pay me now or should I tell her about what you said off camera?
I'll pay you now. We'll get
I'm
that.
Only joking, mum. He's a good lad. He's a good lad.
Good man, sure.
He is. I mean, we mentioned there about YouTube. Now, obviously, I know you've got a channel, John Ha Ha Ha, 555. Yep. If you don't know why we associate Ha and 5, it's because if you count in Thai, number 5 is Ha.
Ha, ha.
So 555 is Ha Ha Ha. But yeah, I mean, tell me about your channel.
I'll start off by saying that I started the channel when the last time COVID came last year. I think it was June last year.
Okay.
Would that make sense?
Yeah.
I don't even know.
Yeah,
the
it was about June, July. It was June, July.
I think it was like June or July, something like that. And one of my friends was a YouTuber, and he was a gaming YouTuber. Nothing to do with like what we're doing now. It was all just games, and he does reviews. And he kept saying to me, John, go down the YouTube avenue. You know, there's people in Pattaya now making YouTube, but I think you've got the personality for it. And that was the reason why I done John 555, John Ha Ha Ha, because I'm not a serious guy at all. I'm quite funny and I like a laugh and a joke. And I thought, well, maybe I could make some funny videos and stuff.
Yeah.
Be not so serious. Because at the time, I looked at the YouTube scene in Pattaya and there wasn't anyone that I found really, really funny.
Yeah.
There was interesting, factual people, but there wasn't anyone that was really funny for me.
Yeah.
And my friend was like, well, there you go. John 555, and that was it. And I started it, and I started making some videos. I was just walking around and speaking Thai and stuff, and just being.
How'd you find
a bit
it?
Crazy. Well, the channel took off decently. I mean, I don't know everything about YouTube, but my friend said your channel's taken off decently. It's going on a good path.
Yeah.
Continue with it, and then here we are today. So.
Yeah, brilliant. Well, there you go. So if you haven't seen John's channel, I'll put a link in the description below. Go check it out, John. Ha ha ha. Have a look, and you know. I've seen some of your videos. You know, you're right, mate. You wander around. You get about.
Thanks, mate.
You know, it's good. It's a good channel, guys. Check it out. Have a look, and you know, please subscribe and follow this young man here.
Thank you.
And enjoy his videos.
That's it.
Now, before we get off, because we're in part two, I'm going to talk to you about your work here now, which is obviously in the cave, which is a little bit different to what we're talking about. But before we go into that route, what I want to ask you is, imagine everything's now back open, everything's exactly as it was pre-COVID, how we were so used to. Where's your go-to place?
If I could magically make Soy 6 great again, it would probably be Soy 6. Could just throw it, you know, a magic wand and make it all back to normal again. Yeah, Soy 6 in its heyday. Mm. Soy 6 in its heyday would be probably before I came here.
Yeah.
I was here for 4 years, I'm talking. Maybe even just when I came here, that was the magical place that I remember. And then Walking Street too, and I wish I could magically just put myself as on holiday and never been here again, and hit like Soy 6 and then hit Ibar, because now I can't really think anything worse than being in Ibar. I've been here for 4 years. For me, Ibar is just like not a good experience.
But I wish
I could just be there and be as crazy as I was back then and just go on Ibar and buy bottles, but now I just don't see the magic in it anymore.
I mean, when you came out here, did you come out here to work? Or was you on a holiday? So you'd already planned to work?
Essentially, yeah. One of my friends was working here and he had a job lined up. I didn't. And he said, I'll get you a job. And he said, I was like, And he was like, how much money have you got? And I told him, it wasn't a lot at all.
Yeah.
He says, you're stupid. Come over, I'll get you a job. And I'm that kind of guy. I'm that kind of guy that just does it. And I just came and I had a job within 18 days. I had a cover manager job on Soy 6.
Brilliant, fantastic.
Within 18 days. So.
Well, respect to that, because, you know, I like people that have got the nuts to get up and just do something.
I could have been sitting here going, we're here with John, he's homeless.
Yeah.
He's been here for 4 years, he's eating rice every day, he's not got any money.
He's carrying bag suitcases outside.
He's hoping to sleep on that couch today. But yeah, essentially.
It does take a certain amount of guts and steel to
up
sticks, leave what we're comfortable in. Even if we may not like it, we still leave it behind. And it is a comfort zone. You know, you come here, you're exposed to no social, no support. You know, it's very lonely here on our own in terms of support from the services.
I didn't really get a lot of help from the guys that were here. I find that guys don't really help a lot of the people. And that's why, essentially, I try and help as many people as possible, because it is really hard and it's a daunting thing, the whole Pattaya, the whole Thailand culture, it's a hard thing.
Yeah.
And no one really helped me that much. I had one guy who did say, come and I'll help you out, but most of the other guys, I was sending messages, can you help me? Like, I'm busy just now. I was thinking like...
Yeah.
So I do try and help as many people as possible.
Well, fair play to you, my friend. Fair play to you. Well, that concludes today's part one of our interview here. So, guys, thank you so much for watching. Part two will be out on Friday. And on Friday, I'm going to see how good he is at Thai. We'll see. We'll get a pen and paper out and he can start writing it down. No. Let's see how good he is at Thai. But we'll come back to that on Friday. But anyway, in the meantime, it's been a pleasure, my man. Thank you so much.
Buddy.
Absolutely brilliant. Guys, please check out his channel. Have a look. John555. I will put a link down in the description below. And please take a look and you know, follow him and see what journey John goes on, because we're very different in what we do. All right, that's it for me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please, as always, remember, hit the subscribe button and also the bell icon if you'd like to be notified when I bring out a new video. Check out our members area. There's more and more members joining each and every week. Please take advantage of that. I will send you your digital ID card and you can go into various businesses here in the city centre and claim your discounts back, etc., etc. And join our Telegram group. We've got so many on there. Brilliant, guys. Great crack. Lots of photos. It really is a fun go-to place. So please have a look at the link in the description below and please join our Telegram group. All right, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching. And please, wherever you are in the world, stay safe.